Okay, greetings to all. I am Alonzo, and Ainda is going to be sharing on some information that I believe it to be useful, especially in these times, and it's regarding Rastafari's Sabbatical Study number 45, including Deuteronomy Torah portions through Deuteronomy chapter 3, verse 23 to chapter 7, verse 11, and then we have the prophets and the New Testament. New Testament, Matthew and Mark, and then we have Isaiah chapter 40, verse 1 to 26, or around, something similar to that. But just keep in mind, that everything I say, I'm not that great at organizing stuff, but everything is related. So just keep a sharp ear and try to make those connections, because everything I can assure you is some way or somehow intermixed, because there's a lot of material that it would make no sense to try to organize it. So, and I just gonna see what happens. And just a just a word of encouragement. Our God and Father, the Emperor, first power of the Trinity, he in his in the autobiography, His Life, Progress, and Ethiopia, he does diligence to remind, like, every almost it seems as if almost every instant possible to remind the ones and ones that that life is this up and down roller coaster, and so it's up to I and I to know how to ride the waves, because in a world so negative, even positive is eventually going to be affected by all this negativity. So take care not to be I guess being too hard on yourselves. Sometimes I guess negative patterns, or just that feeling of anxiety or eagerness, or just those moments when where I and I is up in the mental, in the consciousness, are confronted with controversy, just hang in there, stay strong, and scripture and studies really do help to keep ones firm. But it's gonna so if you're having a not that great day, overcome that scenario, overcome that moment, and know that the I shall triumph and shall overcome, for I and I is overcomers. We pass over these obstacles, and but it's so ones wouldn't be too hard in the sense of maybe blaming themselves. It's not a blame game. It's about perfection. It's about becoming at peace. His Majesty clearly demonstrates that, you overcome one obstacle, and then you're confronted with another one. So let us not bring ourselves down because of that. It's life, and it's a matter of if we persevere. So hang in there, ride the waves, and keep afloat. It's a perfect time to kind of, but I ain't trying to advertise or anything, but it's a good visual of when Peter, well, Jesus Christos is walking on water, right? And then Peter begs him to Adonai, can I come, can I walk on water? And he does. But so he starts walking, right? Peter starts walking, but then some winds pick up, some philosophies. The winds could be interpreted in so many different ways, but ultimately it's referring to, like, to something that's gonna unbalance you. And so Peter doubts, and but know that Jesus Christos will always be there to pick you up, because you actually tried, and so it's not the end of the world if you doubt a little. It's just a matter of reflection and contemplation and meditation and to overcome that and not doubt again, you know, to learn. So, you know, and then Jesus Christos, you know, sustaining the scripture in his bosom, in his heart, in the radius, which is it's all related to this Torah portion. It basically it comes down to what's in your heart. So if you're of a, it doesn't matter what the outward appearance or what you say, what you pretend to be doing, how in what manner do you act? It comes down to what's in your heart. And I cannot read hearts, but you know, you can't fool judge. I know exactly what's going on inside of each and everyone's heart. So, you know, if you're not in the spirit, you know, don't even pretend, because Jano, you know. So give us just 1 second, please. Okay, continuing. So we're told to be workmen, need not be ashamed, right? So what is a workman? We could go to, I remember the scripture, and it's all related. Jonah, you know, he's in that boat, you know, and you know, there's a storm, same scenario, you know. So if you open up your scripture, here's a little side note, for those that maybe aren't that interested in studying scripture and really focusing on the studies, but you know, forgive if this isn't all that, if what I'm about to say isn't all that, you know, like right. Well, let me just say, you know, like even if just for ones to, for their own selfish reasons, I would suggest, you know, that studying scripture will increase and improve whatever it is that you all do, you know. So whatever your hobbies, whatever you're into, whatever if be it sports, music, writing, whatever it is that you enjoy, by studying, I assure you that your skills will improve dramatically. And I think it has to do with the fact that the spirit wanting, well, this, okay, so you take in information, and so now you have money in the bank, right? But knowledge in the bank. And then the spirit, whenever you're doing anything, the spirit just you may not remember, but the spirit has a whole bunch of archives that it could go through. And so let's say you're playing basketball, the spirit will go into your archives and it'll start disseminating and rightfully dividing all physics and all measures and weights and balance and you know, and philosophy on jumping, you know, it'll do that. And I can assure you that just by studying, you could be off the court for a month and you could study nonstop, and then you get back on the court, and it's like if you've been practicing like nonstop for the past few months. What I'm trying to say is that take advantage of studying. It'll increase every aspect of your life, because the knowledge, just knowing, is so powerful. Your spirit or your mind will, if your soul isn't able to pick up on certain things that might benefit you, the mind or the spirit will kind of like take the initiative to it'll feel with the authority to kind of exclude your little psyche that isn't really benefiting from these studies, and it'll actually do things for you. So you'll find yourself improving in different areas of life and doing things that you had only thought before. But you know, thought is a vibration. Once it's there, you know, eventually it'll manifest in words, and which is another advice, you know, say whatever it is you want to do, you know, tell Jah, you know, yell it to at the top of the scream, at the top of your lungs, you know, make it clear what it is that you want. So these are just, you know, I guess tips and ideas. They're not ideas, they work, you know. no one can answer a question if you don't ask it, you know? And if you don't say it out loud, well, no one can hear your voice. It's like, you know, those that are called, they hear their voice because their voice has been uttered. Those whose names have not been called cannot hear because there has been no calling. So, you know, ask, knock, and thou shalt receive. So, you know, that was not off track, but not the main focus. You know, I just want to make sure everyone in Rastafari knows that we are all dealing with difficulties and persecution, some worse than others, in some ways, some in other ways. Nonetheless, that is why I highly encourage, and I would love for all brothers and sisters to be a little more to communicate a whole lot more, because it is through communication that ones will find not only the comforter in spirit, but find a brother that'll pick another up when he, you know, like Jesus Christos picking up Peter from him almost from drowning, you know. We gotta have that buddy system put in place. So, okay, Jonah chapter 1 verse 8. We're gonna start from verse 8. Okay, so starting from verse 8, then said they to him, "Tell us, we pray thee, for whose cause this evil is upon us." I'm just gonna jump right ahead and say it. Don't be accusing yourselves. Don't be accusing others. Worry not about the cause, but rather focus on the effect. What is I and I to do? You know, how is I and I gonna overcome this? So we could play the blame game, or we could just deal with the matter. And all that time we would have invested in figuring out whose fault it was, that could have been applied to the perfectioning of overcoming, passing over this obstacle. Once obstacle, now history, now shaft blown by the wind of truth. So continuing, so Jonah's in the boat, and this is the sailman or mariner speaking. And what is thy occupation? The mariners ask Jonah. And whence comest thou? What is thy country? And of what people art thou? And the answer is brilliant. And he said to them, this is Jonah speaking, "I am in Hebrew, and I fear the Lord, the God of heaven, which hath made the sea and the dry land." So, what is our occupation? We are Hebrews. What country are we from? We have passed over to the land of no countries. Our God is the God of the creator of heaven and earth, and the earth and the seas, you know, and he dwelleth in heaven. And what is thy country? Well, we have overcome this world. We have passed over to the world to come. What are thy people? Those that are Hebrew, those that have passed over to this truth. And so, what is thy occupation? To fear the Lord thy God, you know, and keep his commandments. So that's a perfect description of what it is that I and I are to do as workmen, need not be ashamed. And the perfect scripture for I and I would be Job, because what's our job? Our job is to fear the Lord thy God, that is one, and keep his commandments. And by doing so, then we shall abide in love, in the love, in the truth, and the light that is the life of men, which is the love of Jah, you know, Jah is love, Jah is light, and Jah is truth. So Jah is life. So we'll get into some details regarding that, but so we're gonna do a little. We're gonna go into the book of Job. So if you want to get your scriptures ready for that, now, just before and I get started, it's going to be dealing with the real repentance and being born again. Listen, I would encourage anyone to call in the name of the Lord, that I and I God, you know, that is one, to accept that blessed be him that cometh in the name of the Lord, Adonai, even Jesus Christus, and even the first power of the Trinity, Haile Selassie the first, you know, Kedamawi. And so I say that because repentance plays extremely important role. It's what gets you in the right track. It's what gets you going in the right direction. But first, it requires a pure heart. It requires to really want it. And this applies to faith and to your prayers. You have to really know that you want it and be true. You know, it has to come from the deepest. You have to look deep into yourself, you know. And it's like, I've described it as a state in which you are completely empty, you know, lacking all substance, just like nothingness, but at the same time, like strengthened and kept intact, kept bound by completeness, you know, by fullness and by the all. So it's, well, that's kind of like one would think that's confusing, but I pray that many know what I am trying to describe, you know, that feeling of emptiness, but still that pure fullness, because you're still hanging on, but you're hanging on to nothing, but you're hanging on to everything. It's you know, Ja Ruling, the study will explain that, but in other words, it has to be pure and true. You have to really, really, really desire it, and that is what this study is all about. And I besought the Lord, and I humbled myself to the Lord, and I pitched my tent to the Lord. It, kneel down, bend down to I guess drive the stakes into the cross, but in this case the tent, and the heel grabber, you know, like Jacob, to grab that heel. Just picture Yehoshua HaMashiach, like right in front of I and I just prostrating and just like slamming our faces on the ground, not to the extent that we get hurt, right? But you know, in Jesus Christus, what is hurt? You know, non-existent. So, you know, but humbling down and you know, like beseeching, like really desiring and begging and grabbing a hold of that heel to demonstrate that you want it, you know. And so there's a process, and that will eventually as soon as you manifest that testimony, Jah will come straight to you, because he knoweth the heart. So Jah will come straight to you and like lightning and like the wind. You can't see it coming. You don't even know where it comes from, but you can see the effect, you know. And it's gonna be the same deal. And the reason I mention that is because I'd like to encourage that even the sinners of sinners, you know, you can continue. Well, I'm not saying that ones out there are doing it, but for sure, there are. I don't know among Rastafari, and I'm sure there are cases, but anyone that wants truth and wants peace, or at least the possibility of peace and comfort, don't let whatever you've done in your past keep you back from the only thing that is true. That is the life, the light, the love that is Jesus Christus and the Father, you know, that is within your heart if thou art of truth, you know. Don't let anything you've ever done keep you back, you know. Don't torment and torture yourselves by past doings, because if you are pure of heart, honestly, Jao will come to you. He's not looking for ones that have not sinned all that much. He's looking for those that are really, really want it, and that it's the desire of their heart, you know, that are willing to empty, like, to manage, to those that are in a point of you know, making that turn, you know, turning back to Jah, you know, like making that change in attitude that is necessary, that we must achieve, you know. And I kind of lost the idea, but okay, so it's, you're in a point of complete emptiness, so your cup has been emptied, but or maybe even broken. But that's not all that bad, because then Jah will replace it with a new cup, because you don't want old broken cups, you know. Jah don't want that for his house, you know. So he's gonna get a new cup and replace it with a new cup, with that new person, that change of mind, you know, that transformation, not confirmation to the world. And the emptying of the cup, you know, empty it out with tears, with screams, with pain. That's all right, because Jah come to the aid, for he will not forsake that. And so he'll fill it up with life more abundantly. And so what cup are we talking about? Well, the vessel, you know, the land of the body that carries, that eventually can potentially become the dwelling place of the Almighty Creator that is good. And you know, it ultimately comes down to the heart. The life source where the sustainer Igazi Abhid dwelleth, and make it a home if suitable, to if it becomes the environment in which the sustainer, the Almighty Amlak, you know, can dwell. And why is it the heart? Because the heart is, you know, it pumpeth the blood, and the blood is the life. And it pumpeth that new wine, and it's that source of the Nile, you know. Everything floweth from the Nile, and that source is the Almighty Creator that is good, you know. In these latter days, by revelation of truth, is Kedamawi Haile Selassie the first, you know. Oh, well, my bad, Kedamawi is the first. But the King of Kings, elect of God, conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, Emperor of Ethiopia, and descendant of King David, root of David, through the union of Queen Sheba, Makeda of Ethiopia, and David of Jerusalem. And, you know, not to forget, make mention that of Ethiopian complexion, Ethiopian seed of African skin, black, dark skin, Ethiopian skin, you know, and from that race, as is Jesus Christus. Of course, you know, proclaim that to the top of our lungs. There is no shame, you know, in the rightful division of truth. You know, the light shined in darkness, but the darkness comprehended it not. Soon, you know, Jah William, really quick, we'll get to that. But keep that in mind, you know, the light shined in darkness, but those darkness, not knowing itself to be so, for it is not even, so it cannot comprehend how the light is darkness. And this is all scientific. If you want to get all scientifical about it, you could even call it dark matter, which is what most of the universe consists of. So that's a little out of topic, but yeah, don't torment yourself. Jah will forgive you. As a matter of fact, Jah is kind of interested in the sinner of sinners, you know, and those that are okay. Before I continue that thought, let me just say that I and I, as sinners, as sinner of sinners, you know, we should kind of be glad, you know, that Jah be looking for such people to save, you know, because and the reason that he looked for, you know, hardcore sinners, I and I could say, is that to whom he forgives more will be that individual, being that he's been forgiven so much, he will give that much more back. And if you've been forgiven very, very few, you've been forgiven just like a few things here and there, that's the kind of return or Issachar, that reward, that compensation, that hire that you're going to receive. Not much at all. So, you know, blessed be him that come in the name of the Lord Adonai, you know, the one God. Because that's quite a bargain right there, you know. So, and it, you know, the book of Job even goes into explaining how certain animals are for certain, are for specific reasons. And for instance, cattle. You could train cattle and tame them really fast, and they're good workers of the land. They'll haul heavy labor for you, and much weight, and gladly do it. And they're easy to tame and you know, have them perform the works that they are to perform for I and I. But they don't make good pets. They don't make good. You will not establish a good friendship. In fact, it's impossible to have a cow in your house, and unless you're kind of like, I guess out there, it'll be quite difficult to live with a cow. But a carnivore, as a lion, you know, sticking to the lion, it'll take a whole lot more time, strength, and energy to tame that lion, but and years even. But eventually, when that lion has been trained, it'll respond way better to its trainer, to the individual, to the human, to the man, in this case, than herbivores. You know, they what will be created, manifested is a tighter bond, and that's exactly what's going on. So take advantage of this. You know, if you want to call it being selfish. so what, you know, let people say that you're selfish by wanting to save your behind, you know, so there's nothing wrong with that, you know, be it the will of His Majesty, our God and Father, and in and through Jesus Christos, you know, like, and via the Spirit of Truth, which is Jesus Christos and the Father, in that sense, be as selfish as I can possibly be, you know, I'll benefit the kingdom and the will of I and our Father. And so, continuing, that was kind of off topic, but continuing. So the book of Job is gonna give I and I like the crossing over, the T-mobilization Rastafari plan of salvation, you know. And so the book of Job gives. It gives a great outline of the design to deal with problems, you know, to prepare the individuals to sanctify and consecrate the individuals for the coming revelation. And so the redemption of Christ, of Jesus even, it's all embedded in the book of Job, and there's a design, it's perfectly designed, and if I and I can execute only through Jesus Christos, then, you know, life everlasting and that promised land, you know. So, you know, continuing, yeah, let's get into Job. Let me see if I don't want to miss any details, because there's some good stuff. There's a lot of important information that'll really, really help. So, okay, so in going into detail of this redemption process, it's a trinity, of course, and it's like there's different kinds of creations, and holiness. Okay, let me just touch on holiness. Bear with that, there's going to have to be a lot of preparation before we can actually get into the actual the study, but it's we have to build a solid foundation to kind of know what's going on. So creation, the stories of creation, a lot of people think that only Genesis has that, but no. His Majesty teaches to keep the Bible holy, because every single part of it is I and I as members of the corporate body. Every text within every letter is a truth of itself, you know. Every book is just as important as the smallest or the biggest or the least or the greatest. So keep that in mind, because all through there's many explanations of the creation story in the Bible, you know. And I bring that up because in a sense our being born again process requires certain creations, and not going astray from that topic, but it's gonna tie into the plan, you know, to the design of the redemption. So I think I'm missing something. Give me just 1 second. So okay, yeah, back to the holiness. You know, if some questions weren't asked in certain scripture, that's because they've been answered in another scripture. Don't think that Jah don't answer everything. It's that you gotta look for it, you know, you gotta really want it. You gotta really go after it. And it'll be given to you. Just all Jah wants, you can't be going wrong if all you can think about is how you want to love Jah and be good with Jah. If that's what's in your mind, you're going the right way. Because even if we make mistakes in Jesus Christos, we will be forgiven because we are in truth, in purity, seeking perfection. So through ignorance, you know, the Father, the Almighty, forgives us for certain wrongdoings. He's willing to, you know, not recall that, not bring it in to the to remembrance, you know, but only if you're pure and honest about it. Because if you're just committing, you know, sin because you think that you're gonna get away with it because you claim to be in Jesus Christ, it's not gonna work that way, you know. That's why it all comes down to the heart, you know. The Father keepeth the Son in the bosom. He's in the, that is where the Son is, in the Father, in the bosom, in his heart, you know. That's where I and I is to keep you know, the truth and desire it and pure it, like purely and in reality, you know, truthfully. So let I and I just continue. We'll get into the creation a little further down, but Job, you know, what does Job mean? Persecuted, calamitous, afflicted, adversity, adverse desires, a coming back, restored to one's senses, you know, so on and so forth. But well, let me give another description of Job. So okay, I thought I had something, but okay, hated, you know, to be an enemy, to be an enemy to, hostile, mercy, keep in mind mercy, but an enemy of David, of Dawid, you know. And what is David, what is Dawid? A man after the Geta heart, you know, the heart of Adonai, of our master. Dawid is a man after the heart, after, oh man, I think I got it confused, after the Lord's own heart. Yeah, I think it's correct, you know. Correct that if I'm wrong, you know. I apologize beforehand if that's the case, but no, I think it's Dawid was a man after the Lord's own heart, you know. And so them that are not after the heart of Jesus Christos and the Father even cannot receive the Spirit, and are enemies of David, and this world is the enemy of David, and this world is, you know, our God's, our good Creator's footstool, you know. So let's pass over. Let's go beyond that. Let's not dwell in the footstool. Let's claim our rightful throne up in the heavens. So I think that should be good for getting an idea of what Job is. And I guess I'll take the opportunity, once again, I'm not trying to advertise, but you know, Jah really put time into this. And so I really hope that ones can learn from this and can receive this, and hopefully Jah willing it'll help ones and ones, because you know Jah worked he planned this like way before time. He's been working on this for a while, so now I'm gonna share with all of you some of what Jah's been working on, and I didn't know until not too long ago. But whenever I feel that I have to do things in a hurry, it's for a reason. And I didn't have internet this weekend, but it was for a reason. It's not Babylon system and stuff like that. Well, it could be, you know, but I'd rather see it as Jah doing what he got to do. Jah doing what he has to do. He don't want me to be wasting my time, you know, because the internet could be like distracting, you know, and it kind of furthers I and I from our spirit. We gotta walk in faith at times, you know, and so I'll admit, you know, you could get caught up with the internet and stuff. So it's I guess I and I gotta balance it. But this is what Jah been working on, you know. So aside from the studies, and this is a perfect example of the true complexion, the Ethiopian description of Adonai, you know, the elect of God, the Son of God that came in the flesh, in the Ethiopian flesh, proudly wearing, need not be ashamed, you know, carrying his crown. And but notice how he's exalted. He's the world is, those enemies of David are the worldly, the sixthorum is the footstool, you know. And so, you know, build on the rock, the third rock from the sun, and get rooted and grounded. But you know, do not just stay there, you know, like I is to pass over, to be overcomers. Let's overcome the world and be transformed, and let the world be the footstool of I and I, but let of I and I big brother, but let the heavens be our throne, you know. So let's reach the heights. And so yeah, like that's the reason this came to be. So stretch forth your hands to God, you know, and if you know Jesus Christos ain't going nowhere, you know, he's firm. I know I don't mean to mock, you know, the spirit or anything, but you know it's significant of how in the case of if it would have been the tabernacle, the stakes would have been driven into the ground, you know, and it would keep your tent from being blown by the wind. In this case, it's the nails, you know. So I hope ones can appreciate this. It's actually the first I did it with oil paints, and it came up I think pretty cool, being that, you know, I can't take credit. Jah did this because I knew right from the back, from the get-go, because I didn't draw it or anything. It just came out really fast, and whenever I do something fast, it's not me, you know, because if it's out of my own will, it'll take me like days to just even get the design. But right from the start, I knew it was Jah was up to something, because it was way too easy, you know. It was way too, and like I've said before, I'm not an artist, you know. But I really desire certain images, and I work on it until it looks okay, kind of like it. Well, I'll leave this out here because there's more. You know, Jah works in threes. There's a couple more that are significant to these. This presentation that Jah is, you know, blessed I and I with, and indeed he has, you know, it's just really comforting how he puts a lot of time into I and I and make it possible. So continuing, metaphysical Bible description of Job. And the reason I thought about Job is because of Issachar, and we'll get to that, right? Because my hire and compensation reward, and well, job, and workmen need not be ashamed, and Isaiah chapter 40, which is the reading in the prophets, was that spark, that kindleth that flame, that ignited the fuse, you know, like His Majesty says in the summit, in the ultimate challenge speech. Who can foresee, or who can know what spark might ignite the fuse? And you know, Jah is light and Jah is a consuming fire. It's all relative. Let it be a spark, and let it ignite enlightenment and your brilliancy. Let it spark you to be brilliant, but let it not be wrath, you know. Let it not sparkle and kindle it that kind of fire, you know. Let it be the positive fire, you know, that which I and I are to seek. So now, continuing, so it's described here as transition of man from personal self-righteousness to the true inner change, you know, of heart and entrance to Christ righteousness, dealing with thought and intent of innermost consciousness. So that's a description of metaphysical definition of Job. And okay, a couple of things. First of all, give thanks and praises to the Lion of Judah Society, Rasa Adonis, that puts in so much effort and hard work, or light work, that light bread, you know. But he make it possible for such studies to be possible, you know. When ones aren't able to purchase certain books, you know, lojsociety.org/study, you know, offers a great variety of free downloads, and that is just genius. It's not only genius and super helpful, but it's kind and generous and so loving and so giving. So you know, something to praise that act, being that we live in a world where everyone wants money for anything, you know. It's an act of that comes from the heart of Jesus Christos, even, you know, that true love, sharing that. So just wanted to give thanks and praises to Wyndham Yadam, you know, for allowing that to be so. And you know, all tuning into this presentation, this sharing of information, take advantage, you know. They charge, you know, people charge for everything, you know. it's a blessing, you know, to have these sources. Now, man, I forgot the next point, but continuing. So, entrance consciousness. Okay, it'll come to I, Jah Willie, but let I and I continue. Yeah, I gotta continue. Okay, so let I and I first go to the there's a three-step design plan or three-step process in the book of Job, and that plays out throughout it's how the script is played out, you know, in this motion picture. I'm going to read from the Metaphysical Bible Dictionary, made possible by the LOJ Society. You know, even Rasa Adonis, so give thanks, truly, sincerely. Okay, the transition of man from personal formal righteousness, which is the basis of all self-righteousness, to a true inner change of the heart and an entrance. Okay, I read that. Forgive that. You know, which deals with the very thoughts and intents of the innermost consciousness instead of merely setting right a few outer acts. You know, like the Pharisees and Sadducees, well, that's in the New Testament reading of this Torah portions. But, you know, so step one is self-righteousness. It would be like declaring, like the word, to throw it out there, you know? But still just looking at the outward. Now, step two would be, in the book of Job, then along came his three friends to comfort him and to argue with him. These friends represent accusations against self and attempted self-justifications of the outer or personal consciousness. So this would be, you know, it would still be the outwardly, but it would be like the Sadducees and Pharisees and scribes. It's hypocrisy, you know. It's like it's playing that blame game, where, you know, because in the book of Job, his friends are trying to say, nah, you're lying. They're like, you probably did something and you're not saying, you know, because, you know, they're making their own personal accusations and that's not the truth. And so, continuing, next came Elihu, and that's interesting because this Torah portion study is in the Amareña. The Royal Amharic language is titled Lemenhu. So I think it sounds similar. Elihu, Lemenhu. But nonetheless, the interpreter of Holy Spirit who opens man's eyes to the real righteousness. The self-righteousness of the outer man is based on outer acts only and does not bring about the reign of love and wisdom in the heart, in the thoughts, words, and the whole life. Seeing this fact, the individual truly repents. Job said, after God had talked to him, I had heard of thee by the hearing of the ear, but now mine eye seeth thee. Wherefore, I abhor myself and repent in dust and ashes. So this would be like step two, like the actual illumination from within of you know, to of the Holy Spirit in truth. And continuing, then comes forgiveness and healing. When Job turned to God and prayed for his friends, his captivity was put away. Them that take into captivity shall be taken to captivity. So let's be like Jesus Christus in that true spirit, and let's forgive them, for they know not. You know, let's not take judgment in our own hands, or passing judgment. There's a word for it, but I don't have it right now. So continuing. And Yahweh gave Job twice as much as he had before. Thus then, the awakened individual forgives and seeks the cleansing, redeeming, transmuting Christ power for the uplift of his apparent failings and shortcomings. He enters into true peace, joy, and abundance. So that's the process, you know? And I'd like to include that even in the book From Babylon to Timbuktu, you know, the revolution, the 360 degrees, that turning around to Jah, that transformation, not confirmation, is described in a three-phase process. And it's first it's declaring revolution, speaking about it, the word. And then secondly is fanaticism, being all fanatic about it, like getting all hardcore about it. You know, I admit, of course I was like that, and everyone just hates you, because you're a fanatic. You know, it gets out of control. At least my personal experience, it did. And so, but then with time, you know, one humbleth thyself and begins to really seek that which is true, and that would be the third step, which would be in the book From Babylon to Timbuktu, would be playing out, acting out, you know, putting in motion the applicability, the applying the knowledge and the practicality, you know, putting it into practice. So continuing with that, I guess let me include all throughout the book of Job, there's a lot of questions. If you want answers, you have to ask questions. Wrestle with thyself. You know, look at look turn to Jah and look at him, you know, try to seek him face to face. Battle with yourself even. You know, wrestle over, but really want it, you know, and overcome that wrestling, and the questions shall be answered, but ask, you know, and ask, be persistent. Have that battle even, like, what was I gonna think about? Okay, so why does this spin in that direction? And why does that spin in that direction? And what's causing this? And like really and you know, and then you straight, you know, straight forth, like, straight out, ask Jah himself, and then, like, but just be patient, you know, just be patient and watch and pray, you know, really watch, you know. Observation is you can hear the word, but that's the first step, but then you have to really observe it and see him. You got to really see the truth, and that's very important, just because life is a motion picture, right? It's all illusions, right? Except for truth, which is in darkness, which is the only thing that radiates truth, radiates light and life. The rays coming from the physical sun are kind of that which we can see, are it's visible light, but it's not true. It's radiance is it's, how can I explain this? It's not true, you know? It fades away. So, yeah, but Einstein is not going to get into that right now. But motion, okay. Really, really watch, you know, be a watcher. And questions, you know. The perfect design of Jah and holiness is, it's, there's no question that cannot be answered, but you have to really take the time to meditate upon certain things and wrestle with thyself, with thy penile even, and overcome, you know, but be watchful and be diligent to seek answers where thou expected them least, because truth will not be necessarily visible. Like in the in this visit vis, vis in this, like, worldly secular visibility, rather, darkness doesn't have to be like just complete blackness, but darkness could be the radiance of energy, which is truth, manifesting itself in obscurity, you know, kind of like in on the down low, like, kind of like only if you're in that spirit can you even notice it, you know. It's actual in some cases there's actual events going on, but only those that are in the spirit can actually consider and take note of those events and actually even know that they're occurring. But it comes down to being watchful, ask questions, you know, all throughout scripture, whenever questions are being asked, especially in a poetic form, and we'll get into that. It's most likely Jah himself taking the go it's the prophets or whoever the it is, the case may be. It's Adonai being, or it's the individual being taken up by the spirit, you know, and it's Jah word, like, straightforward. It's him, you know, his majesty even. So, okay, I guess continuing with that would lead Aendai to Okay, before Aendai go into the poetics, which is interesting, let Aendai open scripture to Psalm 104. You know, excuse I like I said, bear with if I don't have everything prepared. But consider that even though Jah is a god of order and everything in order, time is non-existent in the sense of linear time. You know, if you look at scripture, no way is it like chapter 4 of I don't know, of Deuteronomy is 1935, chapter 5 is from 1950 to 1960, chapter 6 is that's not the way it works, you know. His works are holy, and he's got to be dealing with all kinds of things. So, for instance, it took around roughly 2,000 years for the child to be born in Ethiopia, you know, Lich Teferi even. So while that's going on, Jah be working on other things that so that everything works out. And so let's pray that this presentation works out, you know. That's kind of like an excuse for not organizing, but it makes no sense to organize it in this case. So yeah, Psalm 104. It must be really boring, right, to watch the video, but you know, pray that God illuminate me with charisma to present this in a more entertaining way, or I should ask for that. But nonetheless, it's really good information, helpful in more ways than one. So Psalm 104, forgive I for having such difficulties in finding it. So blessed art my Lord God, art very great and clothed with honor and majesty, thou coverest with the light. So thou coverest thyself with the light as with garments, stretcheth. Okay, so who stretcheth out the heavens like a curtain? That's, you know, if you want to be all scientific about it, that's scientific, you know. That's describing an expanding universe. Take that in consideration. So when it's questions like this, it's intended to humbleth the reader, I and I in this case. It's Jah like asking these questions, you know, beautifully written and well structured, but don't overlook the fact that it's trying to humbleth I and thyself. Don't look for the cause, you know, worry about the effect, you know. The cause, it's because Jah's consecrating you. He's you know, if you're going through tribulations, because Jah love you that much, you know, he want to perfect you. So you know, just fear the Lord, loveth him with all thine heart, you know, Shema Israel, and all shall be good. But he kind of wants to bring to remembrance that who the do you think you are, you know, like trying to accuse Jah, who. In this case, it would be like, who stretcheth out the heavens like a curtain? Who layeth the beams of his chambers in the waters? Who maketh the clouds his chariots? Who walketh upon the wings of the wind? Who maketh the angel spirits, his ministers, a flaming fire? Who laid the foundations of the earth that it should not be removed forever? You know, thou coverest it with the deep as with a garment. You know, the water stood above the mountains. You know, this is kind of like the voice of thunder. They hasted away. You know, that this is not wanting to confront Jah. At thy rebuke, they fled. You know, confront it. You know, like you know, like bear the rod of correction and you know, it'll hurt for a little while, but get over it. You know, it's for the best to give up that pride and you know, accept correction. It, you know, blessed be him that can be corrected. You know, brothers and sisters really ask for that because it's hard to admit that one is wrong. And but when you're over that false pride, it opens the gates to a lot of possibilities. So thou hast set a bound that they may not pass over. This is most likely going. It's definitely relative to the Torah portions in this case to either Matthew, I believe, or Mark chapter 12 or Matthew chapter 23. But it's in the studies. We're not going to go over the whole psalm, but just to give you an idea how it, not just the Torah portions are in fact related, but there's so much out there in here in the book of life, you know. He causeth the grass to grow for the cattle, and the herb for the service of man. That he may bring forth food out of the earth, and wine that maketh glad the heart of man. You know, empty that old cup and fill it up anew. And oil to make his face to shine. You know, Jaja is a consuming fire. Light even. Bread which strengtheneth man's heart. Bread is our wisdom and our understanding and our knowledge and our perseverance even. Just gonna throw that this out there. Part of the main focus of this Torah portion is to make thy wills obedient to good influences. There is no greater wisdom. Man cannot go beyond that. You can, it makes no difference if you know the cause of a certain effect. Even if Jah were to tell you, you still don't know. You were informed for starters. That wouldn't even mean that you know. You were just informed. Only the Almighty knows, for He is all knowledge. He knoweth all things. But for I and I, our glory is keeping the commandments. You know, following. You know, Jesus Christus testified to this. The Spirit testifies to this. Our Father Kedamawi Haile Selassie testified to this. Keep the Ten Commandments, which are one. You know, make your wills obedient to good influences. That's the greatest wisdom. You cannot go beyond that. Somewhere within this portion, it we'll come across the text where it's the scripture where it says that this is, you know, these statutes and judgments and ordinances. Or I don't know if ordinances and laws will be your righteousness, your wisdom, and all nations will be like, oh, well, we'll get into that like soon enough. So yeah, let's just excuse me. You know, thou sendest forth thy Spirit, they are created, and thou renewest the face of the earth, even thy and thy. That thou hidest thy face, they are troubled. Thou takest away their breath, they die, and return to their dust. You know, but then we shall overcome and be reborn. from above. So let's go to Proverbs. Book of Proverbs 8. These are descriptions of the creation, which is also in the book of Job. But Job is so interesting, but I and I is not gonna even go into that. Just what is necessary to complete what was lacking in this Torah portion. Rastafari Sabbatical Study 8. Doth not wisdom cry, and understanding put forth her voice? Seek it, make it known, express it to the top of your... at this point, it's a sad, sorrowful voice, but nonetheless... soon to be a joyful, loud sound noise to the Lord. But yeah, but make it known. She standeth in the top of high places, by the way, places. Okay, let me just skim through this. O ye simple, understand wisdom, and ye fools, be ye of an understanding heart. Hear, for I will speak of excellent things, and opening my lips shall be right things. Let us desire that which is right, make our wills obedient to good influences. For my mouth shall speak truth, and wickedness is an abomination to my lips. You know why the heathen and the wicked and you know why they hate Ayandai? Because when Ayandai speak, Ayandai shine light. Ayandai, what cometh out of Ayandai mouth is truth, and it's love, and it's light, and it's the life of men. But lifeless or darkness does not understand it. It flees from it. It fears in some cases because they don't they can't get over themselves that, oh, but what I did before, get over it. We live in times when you gotta be really, really bad to be among the worst. So whatever it is you've done, sadly, this unfortunately being the circumstances, it can't be that bad, So get over yourself, give yourself the opportunity to be forgiven, but first you gotta get over yourself, Repent. So continuing, kind of lost my place. Okay, all the words of my mouth are in righteousness. There is nothing froward on perverse or perverse in them. They are all plain to him that understandeth, and right to them that find knowledge. Receive my instruction, and not silver, and knowledge rather than choice gold. You see, it ties in perfectly with the prophet section of this Torah portion. For wisdom is better than rubies, and all the things that may be desired are not to be compared of it. I, wisdom, dwell with prudence and find out knowledge of witty inventions. So, the fear of the Lord is to hate evil, pride, and arrogancy, and the evil way, the froward mouth do I hate. Counsel is mine, and sound wisdom. I am understanding. I have strength. So on and on, gives you an idea of what a Guan, continuing. I'll just add this last little section here. When there were no debts. This is Proverbs 8, verse 21. Yeah, 21. That I may cause those that love me to inherit substance, and I will fill their treasures. The Lord possessed me in the beginning of his ways, before his works of old. I was set up from everlasting, from the beginning, or ever the earth was. When there were no depths, I was brought forth. When there were no fountains abounding with water. Before the mountains were settled, before the hills was I brought forth. While as yet he had not made the earth, nor the fields, nor the highest part of the dust of the world. When he prepared the heavens, I was there. When he set a compass upon the face of the depth, that turning around, that compass, that compassing, that compassion even, 360 degrees. When he established the clouds above, when he strengthened the fountain of the deep, you get the picture. Okay, hear instruction and be wise and refuse it not. Blessed is the man that heareth me, watching daily at my gates, wait at the post of my doors. Okay, at the entrances, at the at the openings, you know, at the change, notice, you know, patterns. Time is patterns. You know, it's not that time passes like they tell us, it's that patterns happen. And we can kind of like notice that, okay, whenever that happens, and that happens simultaneously, that happens, you know? So this will really help, you know, watch the gates, the opening and closing of Jah works, you know? The book of Job can describe how, in one form of interpretation, how the two stones that were set by Jah, you know, can be both the scripture brought down from heaven. You know how Moses says, I call upon heaven and earth. So earth would be nature, and the scripture would be calling heaven as witnesses. So we got these two stones, and so we have nature and scripture, so nurtured from the heavens, and then nature from creation. So we have this psychological like so-called advancement in Western studies that has been there since the beginning. You know, naturally it was in our hearts, and we messed that up. We you know, that went bad, quick. You know, almost quick like lightning. You know, just as quick as lightning, unfortunately. But then we were nurtured. So, you know, so even Job, you know, at the beginning he was a good man, whatever, nurtured. But understand that before Jesus Christos came to being, nothing was. But that's because all those that were even righteous still were outwardly, even Job, because he was still proud. Moses even, in a sense, is proud. Most of scripture, whenever one transgresses, it's pride. Even going back to the Garden of Eden, you know, as previously discussed, it's that pride, you know, that naked I and I transgress, humble it in thyself, you know, and keep the border let's be borderless, you know, to keep that blue border being the heavens. But see that perfection, that the wholeness, like, we're not limited to anything, but then again, we're limited within the border of not transgressing the commandments. But there's no limits, because we wear like blue embroidery or borders on our garments, you know, meaning that our limit is the heavens, and the heavens pretty much have no limit because they're expanding, so they're everlasting. Once again, you know, like all kinds of studies, or, you know, subjects of study being perfectly described and you know, set out both in nature and in scripture by the Almighty Creator that is good. So you know, I said before, not knowing exactly what I said, but being guided by the Spirit, that, you know, just man thinks so arrogant that, you know, earth has been around for millions of years, they said, even if it's thousands. I accept it to be way more than thousands, for sure, millions even. But and Jah kind of gives a hint to that. But continuing, man comes along and he's 40, 50 years old, and he thinks that he knows better, so he starts doing things his own way. But we can learn from nature. The answers are in nature. And you know, the book of Job teaches that in order to solve the economical problems of today and the natural problems and everything, one does not have to sacrifice morality or ethics. You know, like His Majesty said in the Ultimate Challenge speech, we Africans will fight if necessary, and we are confident that we shall win, because we're confident in the victory of David beats Goliath, of truth over evil. Good over evil. And so, but then he goes on to say, now I don't think You know, I'm not going to cherish these illusions. I'm not going to pretend and make believe that I think it was Portuguese and forgot, and South Africa are willing to commit both physical suicide and economic suicide. But if ways to I gotta go there because I lost it. Give I just 1 second. Okay, here we go. So I do not believe that Portugal and South Africa are prepared to commit economic or physical suicide if honorable and reasonable alternatives exist. I believe that such alternatives can be found. We must act while we can. You see, Jah within its creation, redemption is within Jah creation. It's never separated from itself. It's the oneness, it's in the whole. And it's complete, lacking nothing. So the answers to our questions are first of all, we have to turn to 300. Well, we have to turn to Jah, and then look deep within ourselves, you know. But there are answers, honorable and reasonable solutions to all the problems that we are confronted with. We do not have to sacrifice moral values and ethics for the accomplishment of ridding ourselves of solutions, you know. So let's learn from nature. We have this big problem where we try to solve a problem and we do practically what is worse. And I'm gonna take this time to mention that I've really taken seriously the watching and praying, meditating and watching. We as a humanity are, it's unfortunate to have to admit this, but it's true. We don't know what we're doing. We have no idea what we're doing. We have no idea. And please, brothers and sisters, I'm not exaggerating. Really, really try to overstand this, overcome this. We have to be love. We have to be lights, the light of the world. We have to walk in the council of Jah Rastafari, you know, keep it his commandments. Because most people don't have the slightest idea how ignorant we are as a race, as a you know, world community. So my fleshy young brother is 19 years of age, and he just had a newborn daughter. And I'm not too cuddly, you could say. And I have practiced the Amareña with her, and you know, we deal in the mental, but because I don't want to start instruction. Well, that's not necessary to go into. But what I make sure to do is it's be aware and be a watcher and watch the motion picture that's being played out. And just watching, you know, every single event that would seem in other circumstances insignificant, but my brother and his girlfriend had an argument, and I couldn't stop thinking, what's gonna happen? what's gonna happen. You know, like I was thinking, surely, well, the daughter is around like probably a month, if even that, maybe like 20 something days. Yeah, like maybe let's say a month, but it's the first argument at least that I know of, and but I knew that whole night that I couldn't stop thinking about it. I knew I want to see the young daughter. You know, I want to see this. I want to see the effects of what this is gonna be. You know. Surely enough, the next day, the first thing that I already knew, but I had to ask to confirm it, and I kind of heard as well, but so I asked my mom, because she was dealing with the daughter, and I said, has she been crying more than usual? And my mom said, yeah, you know, my brother's girlfriend had mentioned that she had been crying quite a lot, you know. Up to this point, she had never cried so much, and I just knew right there. Well, I knew before that, but that just confirmed it. It's like, we have no idea what we're doing. We have no idea the effects that our actions and our that we produce. You know, walking in the love and the light of Jah is no joke. You know, consider this new creation, an empty cup, and in this person, in this case, that daughter she's got it pretty good. But in other cases, how much, you know, these creations of Jah, you know, they're pure, and they're brought ignorantly into this world without knowing the responsibility that there is behind the raising, the lifting up of this child, to the point where we completely corrupt and twist and you know, mess up the minds of the youth, them, you know. And you know, I don't even know how to explain it, you know, but understand that all this by observation. And really, it's serious, you know, that we gotta walk in love, because you know, these babies are being formed, so anything that happens throughout they're not yet fully grown, so anything that happens that they experience from now to when they stop growing, and I would say that's death, will affect and have an impact in their lives. So surely enough, the daughter was crying a whole lot, and I even noticed it, her expression was different. It's like, I'm not saying that, oh, you know, she's going to lose her mind because of this one instant. But that one little instant, that screaming, and it was like, I could just, I know it was torture for her. It's like, it's trauma. So now the baby is, her look was different. Her perspective on life wasn't all that beautiful no more. You know, she was crying a whole bunch because, she had been taught to cry, and not only did it scare her and panic her, but you see those that brought you to life doing it, part of you wants to, you know, do what those that you admire are doing, and you know, confusion and kind of like the innocence being taken away, robbed, you know, unfairly robbed from these children of Jah that we raise up as devils, and that's our fault, you know. Not to say that Jah don't play a role in this, in the redemption process, and some of these cases being for the benefit of Jah will, but nonetheless, you know, it's not fair. Then after that, I started thinking, lower the volume on that TV, you know. It's probably affecting her hearing. And plus, it's, you know, what's on, it's exposing negative vibrations, and like turn that off, you know, like put some like have that child be at peace, you know, you know, like go outside, you know, have her interact with life and with anything that with the with the few things that actually vibrate life nowadays, being that we destroyed most of it. But yeah, so it just got me, you know, and it's to show how observing, you know, but definitely we gotta step it up, you know, because how many children, you know, just lose their minds, you know, and it's not even their fault. It's our irresponsibility, not knowing what we're doing and bringing them to suffer, you know, being that they could be dwelling in a beautiful garden, you know. And I kind of lost track why I'd mentioned that, but the reason is because I'm thinking the way I'm thinking because of Jah Rastafari in and through his son, the authority Jesus Christus, via the Spirit. That is love, you know. That is love. That is wisdom. Because if I'm not saying that I'm the example, no way, you know, I'm a sinner of sinners, but you know, for that particular instance, I overcame and I realized that this is what the world needs, you know. The world needs Jah love, because only Jah love, being that we're now learning that it's wisdom and understanding, openeth the eyes of the individuals and leadeth you to right. And both the mother and father with due diligence to be quick to conclude that yelling is not the solution, that there's a child in presence, and that these vibrations are not gonna affect this life positively. And so only in the mind of Jah, you know, only in that spirit can we overcome. And but this was just an example, mainly to express how the love of Jah is true wisdom, and there's, you know, Jah is that positive light source, and make your wills obedient to that positivity, and you have acquired the greatest wisdom. No genius can go beyond that, you know. And so yeah, you know, it's, let's conclude with that. There's still so much more to cover, to go over, but keep that in mind, you know, this is some serious stuff. And also that, take in consideration that you learn a lot from just from just looking at stuff, you know. You see things in motion, and you start to notice certain patterns. Oh, let me just mention that her eyes were swollen, and yeah, definitely, like, did affect all kinds. And then I saw my mom giving her this vitamin D, because women nowadays are low on vitamin D. True, but I accept that to be true. But take her outside, have her have some sunlight. You know, there's other alternatives, honorable and reasonable, that can be found. But I start reading the box, right? Okay, this does not cure anything. This does not provide anything. This does not. Basically, the box was saying that this is useless. Just marketing, you know, just trying to, consumption. Just trying to. And I tell my mom, it's not that hard, you know, like, get over yourself, get over your pride. All you have to do is not give it to her. You're confronted with the need to have to say that, okay, the doctor's wrong. You know, she's a brand new baby. That's what I told her. It's like she's a brand new toy. You're playing with her like she's a toy, but you're not in the real true love, because, yeah, you say, oh, you're so beautiful, I love you, I give her kisses, whatever, but that's to no effect. Your works are to no effect, because there's no truth behind that, because you're infecting her with liquids that who knows what they're formed out of or made from, because this guy said so. She's brand new, she's a toy, she's not broken, you know, and already you're infecting her with these diseases. She just stayed quiet, you know. She, you know, at those points in time in life, she, like most others, hate I and I, you know, because I and I speak a truth, speak it light, and the light is the life of man, and, you know, darkness comprehended it not. So So yeah, we gotta be really careful what we do, and so give thanks. I don't even know how long we went into this, but hopefully, Ja willing, it wasn't that long. Stay tuned for more. I give thanks. I pray this is helpful, and I hope I didn't bore the brains out of you all. So shalom, Rastafari. Let Ja be I am thy guidance and protection to life everlasting. Shalom.